right for us to be celebrating the 69th Independence Day of India. I shall now read out President's address to the nation on the eve of India's 69th Independence Day. Fellow citizens, on the eve of 68th anniversary of our independence, I extend warm greetings to you and to all Indians around the world. I convey my special greetings to members of our armed forces, paramilitary forces, and internal security forces. I also congratulate all of our sportspersons who have participated and won laurels in various tournaments in India and abroad. My congratulations to Shri Kailash Satyarthi, Nobel Peace Prize winner for 2014, who has done the country proud. Friends, on 15 August 1947, we won political freedom. The birth of modern India was a moment of historic acceleration, but it was also pinched with the blood of unimaginable suffering along the length and breadth of our country. The ideals and convictions that had held through the travails of an epic struggle against British rule were under strain. A great generation of supreme heroes faced this formidable challenge. The sagacity and maturity of that generation saved our ideals from deviation or degeneration under the pressure of emotion, including rage. India's pride, self-esteem, and self-respect, born from a civilizational wisdom which inspired the Renaissance that won us freedom, was distilled into the principles of our Constitution by these extraordinary men and women. We have been blessed by a constitution that launched India's march towards greatness. The most precious gift of this document was democracy, which reshaped our ancient values into a modern context and institutionalized multiple freedoms. It turned liberty into a living opportunity for the oppressed and impoverished, offered equality and positive discrimination to the many millions who had suffered social injustice, and instituted a gender revolution that has made our country an example of progress. We abolished archaic customs and laws and ensured change for women in education and jobs. Our institutions are the infrastructure of this idealism. Other citizens, first inheritance needs constant care for preservation. Our institutions of democracy are under stress. The parliament has been converted into an arena of combat rather than debate. It is time to recall what Dr. B.R. Ambedkar, chairman of the drafting committee of the Constitution, said while making his closing speech in the Constituent Assembly in November 1949, and I quote, "The working of a constitution does not depend only upon the nature of the constitution. The constitution can provide only the organs of state, such as the legislature, the executive, and the judiciary. The factors on which the working of those organs of the state depend are the people and the political parties they will set up as their instruments to carry out their wishes. Who can say how the people of India and their parties will be?" Unquote. If the institutions of democracy are under pressure, it is time for serious thinking by the people and their parties. The correctives must come from within. Fellow citizens, our country's rise will be measured by the strength of our values, but it will equally